Welcome to my new video. In this video, I am going to talk about the worst medical pandemics in history. The first one I am going to talk about is the plague of Justinian, 541 to 750. This is a map showing the spread in red and the originating country in black, which in this case is China. The plague of Justinian affected the Byzantine Empire under Emperor Justinian I. A lot of people died in the Byzantine capital Constantinople, current Istanbul. 40% of the population was wiped out of the city. It came to Constantinople via Egypt on a grain-carrying boat. The Byzantine Empire imported huge amounts of grain from Egypt. The plague was brought to other areas via Mediterranean ports, by sea. So as the farmers of the Byzantine Empire began to die, Justinian expanded his empire and took over the whole of Italy. This spread it further. Nomads, barbarians and rebels attacked the Byzantine Empire as it was weakened by the plague. The plague of Justinian killed from around 25 to 100 million people. This plague never left Europe, it came back as the Black Death. The same virus was involved in both these pandemics. The Black Death, 1347 to 1353. It originated in China and spread to parts of Asia and the whole of Europe. It travelled along the Silk Route carried by Mongol armies and people. So the Mongol Empire had made the Silk Route very important and many people travelled along that route carrying the plague. The Black Death spread to Western Europe, Scandinavia and Russia via Pisa, Italy. So the virus was brought to Italy via Crimea, which is in current Ukraine. The Black Death spread to the Middle East via Constantinople. It's the same route, Egypt to Constantinople to Middle East. People who were uninfected began to not leave their houses as much as possible, so they kept themselves in self-isolation. In Britain, the heat from the Great Fire of London, 1666, killed the Black Death, and so it ensured that there were no traces of Black Death in Britain. The Black Death killed from around 100 to 125 million people. Swine flu or H1N1 pandemic, 2009 to 2010. The swine flu or H1N1 influenza virus originated in a town called Veracruz, Mexico. So it originated in pigs in a barn in Veracruz. The farmer's son got it first, who then spread to the family, who then spread to Mexico. From Mexico, it traveled to North America via humans and to Asia via pigs. Quarantine restricted travel, so the European Union, EU, didn't allow travel from European Union to America and from America to Europe. And vaccines helped kill the pandemic. The swine flu pandemic killed 203,000 people. This is the main hot topic for many people today, the novel coronavirus. It originated in the Wuhan fish market, China, in November 2019. The virus is named SARS-CoV-2, severe acute respiratory syndrome coronavirus 2. It originated in bats, and so when a Chinese man ate a bat, then he contracted the virus and spread it to the other people. The coronavirus gets transmitted from human to human. It has currently spread to all continents except for Antarctica. The novel coronavirus has killed from around 54,200 people and infected four times more. So a thing to note is that ancient plagues like the plague of Justinian and Black Death spread less but killed a lot of people, and the swine flu and novel coronavirus spread a lot but comparatively killed less people. This is because in the ancient and medieval periods, people travelled less. There's a geographic barrier. So people didn't travel from mountains, across mountains. Nowadays we travel a lot and there's no geographic barrier as well. So we can travel long distances in a short time. So we can spread a virus over long distance in a very short time. So thank you for watching. Please like, share and subscribe. As you saw that such a big pandemic like the Black Death, which had 100 to 125 million deaths, could be defeated by the self-quarantining and isolation. So I just have a humble request. Please stay home and stay safe. Thank you.